Oh dear, what's going on, man?
Oh, money.
Put it in there, but you gotta tell them.
Yeah, you gotta tell them what's in that.
Alright.
I didn't have them, I just saw them.
Oh, here's the 20.
Put it in the bank.
Put it in the slot there?
Oh, the slot. Yeah.
I don't need the 20.
Who are we, though? Yo, so we got some weird little GameCom shenanigans going on. Nick Leary, come on, let the kid have a break. Let him play the game. You sit there on camera with your nice hair, let him have some fun. Alright, apparently we have about 27,000 people watching. So I've been told to tell everybody who we are. Oh, wait. They're talking to each other, man. It's not fair. There's too much stuff.
Not starting.
Okay, so right, there's apparently 27,000 people watching. To everybody, we are SDA. This is awesome games done quick, 2013. Coming right up is a delightful brotherly love co-op speedrun with Mike and Mark Kenzie, Werster and mike89, about to do Sonic 3 and Knuckles co-op. And we are currently in Maryland, raising money for the Prevent Cancer Foundation, who are a charity that raise money for research into preventable cancers, stopping cancer before it starts, that sort of thing. And I don't know how much money we've got so far, but it's a whole bunch, so obviously thank you very much. $51,000, so there you go. So, just to say, we have informed the two gentlemen that it is PG-13 rules. Unfortunately, not only are they brothers, they're also Australian, so it means they're going to swear an awful lot. So, they will try their best not to swear, but if you have sensitive ears, maybe cover them for the remainder of this run. We're about to show this gunblade thing.
So this is the grand prize for...
Yeah, so this is the grand prize of the entire marathon. It's a $40 donation to get in. You can get in drawn up to three times for, or I think three and a half times for $150, I think it is. And we also have a grand prize Wii U Deluxe. That's a $30 buy-in. It comes with a Zombie U, New Super Mario Brothers Wii U, and two Wiimotes and nunchucks, and it's and that is a $30 buy-in and up to $100 for more bids for it. And unlike the other prizes, you can donate for these all throughout the marathon, and it doesn't have to be all in one shot. So you can do it incrementally.
Yeah. Like a way to save files up.
All right, so I'm going to try and do as many donation comments as I can before you guys start.
I'm right
going to try and read as much of these as I can before you guys start. So. Well, no, wait, let it start, and then I can't speak at all. I'll give it a go. How about I finish this one, then you can go, all right? The last word is blue, all right? So on blue, you guys can go. This is a $50 donation from... Buford Richardson III, which is, oh sorry, the second, my bad, I'm sorry. It's a $50 donation. It says a first generation stream drifter. I don't really know what that means, but it sounds fascinating. LV Creed here doing my little contribution to the marathon. I've been watching from day one and the marathon is already going extremely great. I'll be watching throughout the week. Got to put my week off out of work to good use. Put this $50 for the midget Sandman glitch and Mike Tyson's punch out. Go sinister. Oh, spoiler alert. Okay, get ready guys. Expect a more generous donation later on in the marathon during the block that's dedicated to a little robot boy in blue.
Alright, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, so this is a very special version of Sonic 3 and Knuckles. This is the version with the intro director's cut. And you'll see what I mean by that in a second.
Yeah.
Gotta go faster. Sup, Knuckles?
So the game never takes control of player 2. And the trigger to start the timer is not for Knuckles to be in a certain position, but for him to be off the screen. So that's how that works.
I got through act 1.
Nice. Beat me. Damn.
Yeah. All right, really? We got $20 from Joshua McMillan. He says, I don't care what this gets used for, I just want to thank all the amazing runners and SDA for putting it together. Which means it got sent to Die Hard, naturally. we got $13 from Dwin Cook, who says, put this towards Ginny's Gangnam Style. Thanks for the marathoning. We got $100 from, I'm going to go that Stefan Ulja, but we can't display non-English characters. This is what you're doing. Scaring me. $100, Frenchie here. I hope you're going to reach the goal. I want to hear the nickname of some friends who look to the stream. Ballad Bird, Labatool, and Kazar, thanks for all.
Love that box.
So there's some shout outs there. Easy peasy.
Okay, yeah.
$75 from Andrew Araki. Put this towards Sonic and Sonic 2. I would like Knuckles to win, but I want things to be more interesting.
Alright, so we've actually only got the rights to this music for about 50 seconds.
Yeah.
Can't use it now.
No.
Oh, every time. If you jump when you release a spin dash, right on that frame, you just jump in place and lose all your momentum. Really dumb.
So that's 1/60th of a second where that can occur. That's kind of unfortunate.
Where's Tails?
He's really slow.
Oh.
Yeah, most of the time at this point, I'm just going to let him drag behind. He causes a bit of lag and that can throw off timing.
Ah.
It doesn't increment the in-game time, so it doesn't matter for that, but it's more for timing purposes. That
it does give Worster an excuse to just blame you at everything, though.
Which he always takes responsibility.
Exactly.
Tails is just sort of there to kill bosses.
Stop by the tube.
Alright, I'm gonna stop here anyway. Okay. I'm gonna go for this.
Alright.
Okay. So...
Can't do it.
Yeah. Well, you wouldn't do it anyway. So, I've kept all my momentum from the spin dash, so you can't pick me up. But there's a glitch here where if you pick... Well, it's not here, it's like everywhere in the game. But if Tails picks up Sonic and then puts him down in the right spot, the game just glitches out and all the characters
What's up, guys?
Go wrong. Yeah, he can't do anything right now. But yeah, hopefully what happens is because my momentum is kept through here, it's no use me going so fast through here and it's going to mess up something after the boss. But it's random whether it works. I'm not in control of it.
Nice. And you can hit those off screen.
That's amazing.
Fingers crossed,
yeah.
OK, Okay, we got $30 from
Yes!
Sam.
Oh. Got it. So the Knuckles cutscene just didn't work. Wow. He just started on the Switch or something, or he is the Switch. I don't really know what it is.
Yeah, I don't know exactly how it works.
We got $30 from Sean Kelly for 96 rings on the Mecha Sonic race, and if I'm lucky, the Mecha Sonic arc.
Just. Okay, so there's a universal timer on the platforms here, and because I hit that spring at the right time, I know I'm gonna make this.
So yeah, what we mean by universal timer is most objects in this game will start moving in their cycle as soon as the level starts, even if they're way off screen. This is the worst boss in the game.
This is by far the dumbest boss in the game. Yeah, I got two hits.
I missed. Go.
You go. What are you doing?
Fine.
By the way, if you think they're all green now, this is nothing.
Okay, there we go. That works.
That makes sense. Thanks to Shield 6.
By the way, if you enjoyed watching these last two acts being done relatively normally, I hope you did, because that's the last you'll see.
Normally
for quite some time.
Okay. Luckily, this countdown's so long, you can get a donation in during it. So, Mark Moodler donated $25. Keep up the good works, gents. No challenge needs for me, though. If possible, can one of you say "Real Racing Roots 99 Grand Prix" in the most Ridge Racer Type 4 manner voice possible? Thank you. Maybe that was the most Ridge Racer I could manage. I'm sorry.
Okay, so dying there is intentional.
Sleep deprivation.
Okay, so we got rid of Hydrosity 1 behind us, so we could just level wrap here. So basically, if you go really, really fast towards the left, you'll go to, like, a minus number, but it's like, what's a minus number? You mean a really high positive number, right? And so it just puts you at the right edge of the stage.
Come back!
Yeah, oh, I'm out of position too. Oh, now I'm
You're way out of position. This is kind of bad, actually.
Oh, wow. What the heck? Get him, Tails.
Oh, the minus number is where your character's position is in the level, the X position.
Oh my god.
What are you doing? That's your fault.
This is
definitely. You come back to the boss, would have been perfect, I'm just saying. Where were you?
I don't know.
I was right there.
Alright, we got $20 from Michael Che, who says, "Keep up the great work, guys. Won this in a Marvel tournament yesterday, so put this towards naming the Fallout file, When's Marvel?"
How's it going, Miglarious?
And Daniel Gregoire says, bad. $25. Nice job on the Metallic Madness skip, guys. Put me in the draw for the Sonic 3 cartridge.
I do. Probably better off with that.
Does it have a new dungeon that has a sound effect and
a Oh wow. Oh,
really?
Hang on. Oh, God. Oh, there we go.
By the way, first you're wondering, those enemies aren't actually spikes.
Yeah. There's a lot of egg spikes in this level. And, okay, it's so kind of like super glide.
This trick is really, really, really dumb. Okay, so I'm going to do a spring right here to get inside this spring. And then I'm just gonna kinda spin dash here. And then, oh, nice!
Wow, that was very quick.
Yeah.
Okay, so the reason that works, this level wraps over and over on itself vertically. Go,
nice.
Yeah, nice.
There's a certain number of levels that don't have a kill plane at the very bottom of the screen. And when you duck, the camera moves down, and then you jump, and the camera goes haywire trying to find you, basically. And then during that time, sprites, like things like springs, don't exist.
Yeah.
So you can rip it in the spring.
Basically, anything that's any objects that aren't directly on the screen, they don't exist. So you can... You can just, like, get through them.
Okay,
what are you doing?
Boss is destroying me.
What?
And when we say wrap, we mean, like, picture the map as being kind of like a circle, or at least a piece of paper that's slightly folded over but not completely, because parts of
just
the back out is horizontal one, so...
Do you want me to go to left? Like the spin dash show?
Yeah, it's two.
Yeah,
it's so
good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, whoops. Oh, wow.
That sucks.
That was you, actually.
Should we have a blame counter going on?
That's what's meant to happen.
I've already lost count, dude.
You just caught me the first time, I think.
Well, I think the number is so high positive, it's now a negative number.
Okay, so you just...
I gamed over.
Keep going, man. Keep going.
You gotta keep going.
Do you want to try now?
As many retries as you can. Yeah,
come back, come back. Nice.
There you got me. Okay. All right. Oh, sorry. Six.
Yeah, okay. It is technically possible to get all 8 hits there at once, but it's certainly difficult.
Does an 8-0 only work on certain configurations?
Yes, actually. There are only a few that don't work, though. Oh. There might only be one. But
okay,
there's one where he goes off-screen.
We got $50 from a Gabriella Timoneri. Said, my best friend died because of cancer, and I want to dedicate this donation, an amazing marathon, to her soul and to everybody who has hope and believes in life. Thanks, guys, for an amazing marathon. Thanks to everyone who supports life. Ciao from Italy.
You mean awesome.
Okay, so this is where things get really weird.
Oh, dear.
Okay.
Damn, that's unlucky. That's... Okay, I'm gonna have to set this up again.
So this is kind of weird with Sonic compared to... Oh.
Where are you going, Mike? Come back.
There we go, okay.
Okay. So that pinwheel has two...
There we go.
Yeah. Okay. So that pinwheel has two very important properties. The first one, so to make you stay on the pinwheel, it increases the gravity significantly and makes it so that it can be applied in any direction. Now, the problem is that the ring boxes below have the same properties as the pinwheel. So all you gotta do is stand on them and, things get strange.
So the way that it breaks these properties is when you jump. And so at the moment, Sonic is unable to jump, which is why he's fighting this boss, and I'm just moving the camera. You don't want to get me, thanks.
I got heaps of time for that.
Okay, and so now he has to hit the signpost as well here. We're gonna get a lightning shield.
It's not necessary, but it will make this much easier.
It's way quicker. It actually is quicker now with my new strat. You can't do that normal.
Yeah, it's true.
And oddly, they said if they jump, they cancel the glitch.
That's not true.
Yeah, it's sort of true. If certain circus houses, you can jump, and it won't cancel the glitch. So you can see both of them.
Yeah, so I can jump off barrels.
Like this.
These things.
Or you can jump out of tails hands.
And so now we're going to keep this through Act 2 and see if we can destroy this as best we can. Oh, man.
Nice.
No, I'm going to wait.
Yeah.
Damn! Oh, damn balloon. Friggin' RNG balloons. They go up and down and the hitboxes do move. It's really cool.
Are they random locations?
No, they're not random locations, but their movement is random. Oh, what am I doing? Right,
there we go. Okay. Patience. Oh! This will still work, yeah.
Oh, because you lose it here anyway.
Oh, that was so close. You can actually go through all these bumpers and not, again, absolutely random. This is absolutely crap.
Oh, that sucks.
You didn't turn the lights off. What's the thing?
Okay, but we're still going to keep Wheel Glitch. I'm just not going to go through here really quick. Oh, damn.
I didn't know you were playing Sonic Scramble.
So now, one more time. That's bad
enough. This trick is actually, that's a bit nifty trying to hit that one, but...
Oh, wow. So this skips the Knuckles cutscene at the bottom, and goes up just as fast.
It also destroys its boss.
It also trivializes the boss.
What?
What
was that?
Alright. And if you thought we broke that level...
Oh, you're just gonna start.
Yeah.
He's gonna need to say that literally every single level.
No. No. Oh, no.
I will catch you so hard.
No!
land on it, please.
So yeah, the glitch in the previous level was just heavy gravity in any direction. The glitch in this level is pretty much no gravity. It's another one of those levels that vertically wraps, there's no kill plane at the bottom. And so with no gravity, you can just stay on whatever slope you want. And so the way we're going to activate this can actually be done in a bunch of places, but it's only really useful in this one.
This is the simplest way to do it.
Yeah.
So I'm going to break this, and that really confuses the game.
So now I'm just going to keep going down on this slope for a long time. Now I'm going this way. This is actually just a consistent method that I figured out.
This is normal. Your internet is not broken.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, one flat. So, and then I hit the left edge and I start rolling. So now I'm going even faster because I'm still going downhill. And now I'm heading off to the right. And so I'm going to try and jump out about now. Yeah, that seems pretty good.
Right. That might be Sonic's path.
Might? Okay. Yeah, nice. Good. Nice. Okay. And so now we're just going to, you know.
Okay, so Ice Cap is really weird because the act border is not where the mini boss is. It's actually in the hallway just before.
Yeah, I'm good.
And so,
by the way, this is Act Two.
Yeah,
right, yeah,
right now.
So we skip the Act One mini boss.
I'm just fighting Act Two boss. Oh damn!
I got the last six. One.
All right, you go, mate. 133 is good.
That is a good time.
That's really, really good.
You could call this an
auto-scroller. Look, I told you.
You got through Act 1. What are you talking
about? Act 2 is coming up.
So it's gonna... We're gonna see Act 2.
Sub-Zero is Act 2.
Act 2.
Zero.
Best speedrun ever. Hey, if you thought we broke that level. Oh, wait.
Are you kidding me, man?
Where am I? What?
Oh my goodness.
Use the bird, Mike89.
Oh,
yeah.
That's the first time in our attempts that I've ever hit the lip of that. Mm-hmm. Of course it happens live.
It's an orange bird. It's all you are, really.
So yeah, if you scroll the screen up, it stays scrolled when Tails catches you, so you can use that to pass through objects as well. And then, yeah, just mess with the game.
Just get to the end of the stage, because why not?
So yeah, this Knuckles boss, you're not meant to be here. And it doesn't operate the same way as Knuckles boss. In Knuckles boss, they're meant to stay away, but in this one, they just stay right next to each other for whatever reason. Oh wow, what the heck? Alright, so now go to the right. So I'm gonna get here. Just because I like rings, and this guy's just gonna, you know.
Yeah.
Magic water.
So you have to die at the start of this stage anyway. Like, you just fall down, and there's a kill plane there, and it takes you back to Sonic's normal launch base, too. But if I've done this right, this guy's gonna kill me instead. Oh no, I didn't.
I think it did, yeah. Okay. Really weird, tricky. We only try that once.
Yeah, if you get a frame perfect spin dash there, which is you have to rev and then release one frame after you rev, not on the same frame, because that means you don't do nothing. You can go and stay on that pipe and go really fast down. And then if you do a frame perfect jump off that pipe, you can get stuck in the wall and then, oh, what the heck? That's not what I do. Oh well. And then you can do a level wrap. I don't need a ring. What? I wasn't trying to get that, sorry.
First one?
No. It's like an ultra swag trip to do there. It's double frame perfect as well. I got the first one, which is one saving time.
See that? He got hit, and I killed the enemy. That was not supposed to happen that way.
It's actually faster to get this invincibility because you can just run through all this. So yeah, this level can be broken, but it's insanely difficult. And the reason we only try for it once is because it's also a subpixel alignment. It just so happens that your subpixels are aligned when you start the level.
Aww.
I need the checkpoint?
I know.
But... Are you gonna kill me? Or are we good?
Both.
Yeah, Tails is probably the only
one to
kill
something.
No, I'm good.
Donations.
No.
This is the dull part of
yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, let's do this. Okay, we've got $125 from Matthew Adams. Says, hey guys, if this donation isn't late, it should put you over 50k. Probably did. Awesome job. My cousin actually researches cancer, which inspired me to donate. This donation goes towards Midget Sandman in MTPO. We got $40 from Maurice Dokes, just sending him my $40 donation, a chance to win that sweet gunblade. You guys are doing a great thing. Keep it up. $20 from Matt Badinia, long-time lurker, first-time donator, been watching every marathon since the first one, it's always been amazing. My grandma beat her breast cancer a few years back, and it'll be nice to see some more success stories. My donation can go to Last Story in Sonic 06, best of love to all, and great Sonic CD run earlier.
Good example of how two characters wreck bosses in this game.
Nice. Okay.
Can we get a time check, please?
Okay, yeah, we got a
Big Arm's one of the best bosses.
We got a $20 donation from Christopher Shell, who says number one mod for Werster stream reporting in. Please put this Christopher Shell. Please put this $20 donation in for whatever my husband though Werster wants. That should be a clue. Sorry I couldn't make the drive out. Sincerely, Captain Cinderquill. There you go.
His name's probably Joey.
Yeah. We got $30 from Zachary Goldglass. Just put this towards the Wii U bundle, thanks.
Okay, so this is by far the dumbest speedruns.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so basically I'm gonna use this door here that Knuckles is gonna use. I'm gonna try and get that to put me into the floor. That's pretty dumb, but that's still doable. Then after that, I again need subpixel alignment to the level wrap here, so I'm gonna pause abuse this. Oh, I died.
Oops.
Yeah, let's try that again.
Alright, we got $60 from Daniel Chan, who says, hello everybody, thanks for organising AGDQ. There are a lot of great runs so far, especially yesterday's Yoshi's Island run. Good job, Carl Swagen. Alright. I'm putting $30 towards the Deluxe Wii U package and $30 towards Very Hard Mode on F-Zero GX.
Here we go.
Best of luck to my brother Yoshi fan. It's time to show everyone the results of your training.
Yes, got it.
And then it says three cheers for Captain Falcon. So.
Did you guys activate level select?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, what?
Whatever. We got $25 from Brandon Pearson, who said, thanks for fighting cancer, donating to Super Mario 3, 100%.
$600.
Already?
Yeah. Okay, so I'm trying to get the lightning shield here. This is by far the hardest item box
it's
to get in the game.
Right.
That's it.
On the left-hand side.
And so because the signpost, it doesn't change when the middle part hits it. It changes when the left part hits it. That one's really tricky to hit. But yeah, if my subpixels weren't aligned there, and that's the worst one for subpixels because you're in no control, just 100% random. You get stuck in Knuckles' path, and the only way out is to die. Oh, wow. It's just, you're done.
Oh, all right. So $5 for a crush death on like a ring box for Tails. Oh. Like one of those like after stage ones.
Yeah.
Wow.
Actually, I was gonna say something about that because everyone in when we stream this, everyone asks about the item boxes. The item boxes are consistent. They're always in the same spot on the Act 1 boss map. Oh, you nearly did it again.
I did.
Yeah, so they're in consistent positions and it's always the same item. So that's a couple of stages now where we've been looking for a lightning shield. We know exactly where it is.
God damn.
Does it depend on where the sign goes?
Yes.
Like where it hit the ground.
Oh my god.
What are you doing? Get me up
it's
there.
At the same time. Yeah.
There we go. Nice. That's
the first time I've ever seen you get that.
That's really tricky to hit that fire shield. And fire shield quake with this boss.
7, 8.
I missed. Okay, so now we're gonna see Sonic do some dancing in this level. So this one's kind of hard to explain because I don't really know what's going on. Basically, the game gets really confused, almost as much as I do. The game thinks that Sonic's in like three different places. It thinks he's like on the ground, in Tails' hands, and on one of the pulleys. And so it kind of messes him up in, I don't even know what to call the state he goes into. It's this, dancing.
This game really doesn't make much sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nah, that's not good. Okay, so I'm gonna have to wait for Tails here. But yeah, it puts him in a weird state that actually isn't useful at all. But what is useful is if you're in that state and then you go into a wall and then you zip out, then you can see this is
no. No.
Okay, so now I'm in a wall and I zipped out and then I'm gonna go back. And now I have slow glitch. And so he's gonna fly me up here and I'm gonna avoid touching everything. And so as you can see, I have a slow glitch.
Wow, this thing even stops.
There's a thing there, so I have to jump, and then, whoa, whoa, whoa!
Steeper angle than that.
There we go. Level run.
What?
That that's a good summation of this entire game.
Yeah.
Oh man.
This is probably the
oh yeah, it's true.
I'm out of rings.
We got $100 from Matthew Smith, who said, here's another fantastic STA marathon for a very worthy cause. This donation is in the memory of my father, who succumbed to cancer 3.5 years ago. I miss him every day. Hello to Dram, Feasel, Minion, and any other SMW or Link to the Past runners at the marathon, or in the audience from MLS79.
That was a really good boss fight. Best possible.
Oh, no.
Oh, good save.
Okay, and we got $40 from Mitchell Gomez, who says, hi everyone at AGDQ. Just thought I would donate $40 to the course. Yeah. Hopefully I can put in some of the donation for the Sonic prize if I'm not too late. And you're not.
Okay.
Hope everyone is having a good time and plan on coming back down in an hour after work.
Alright, so this one is kind of similar, I guess. Good
job. Yeah, I got it.
Up.
What? Drop.
Okay. Yeah, if he zips too far when he's doing that, oh. Good. Okay.
Damn.
Alright.
This is one. Yeah, okay, I got it. Okay, that is the dumbest zip ever. Right there. I wasn't going to like you at all. Basically, there's above the wall, there's a ramp that kind of curves. And if you roll and then fire shield into the curve, you somehow drop down and start doing a zip. And that
drop
gets you.
Shield.
Yeah. That gets you to the boss faster than just keeping slow glitch. I actually got slow glitch when we finished that boss, in case you didn't notice. We both did, actually. And then I just dropped it so I could get it again. So I've gotten it like 4 times in this zone already.
Where are you?
Just here.
Yeah, that's meant to be the background, but the way the glitch works means that the background and foreground values aren't set properly. So we're actually behind the background.
Okay, we got a $50 donation from Lee Pogue, and it's for whatever you two guys want. So I guess you get $25 each. So spend your pocket money wisely, kids.
Yeah, great. Nice. If you call it in the bottom right corner,
I'd say, Mike, what do you want? Your 20? You got both got $25.
Oh, we'll work it out afterwards.
All right. Okay. Sure. The rest of that donation was, you're all doing great stuff, and sorry, it's from Lee Pogue. $50. You're doing great stuff, and everyone knows somebody's dealt with cancer in some way. This can only make it easier for people who have to go through it. Good luck with the rest of the stream. I'll certainly be watching.
Oh no, no.
So this is probably the level you see most of Tails doing what he's supposed to do.
Oh no, what?
Ooh, that's...
You're gonna have to get me back up there.
Yeah.
That's awful, what the heck? I'm killing this guy. Could've gone the whole way.
I probably could have, yeah.
Definitely this guy, no matter what. Because they're just on that. On a really bad time, but that always happens. Oh, that's nice. Why did you keep going? What are you doing? Why didn't you just wait there?
I was trying to just wait there, I wasn't sure I was.
So you kept pressing buttons. Nice waiting. Top effort.
Give that about 3 out of 10.
God damn.
Sibling love right here, right?
Okay, we got $33 from Daniel Vickle, also known as Moo. So this is Moo with a comment not actually containing a pun. Good job with the Sonics, to the Mikes and the Mackenzies. And all I gotta say is there's a subterranean. Oh no, if anybody wants to do it for me, I'm not gonna do it. Okay, good. The $33 was a subterranean hard mode.
What? So.
We got $50 from Stephen Berg, who says, great cause, great way to go about raising some money. Someone get a bar of soap for Werster's mouth. I think you've done very well, Werster.
He has done much better than usual. Which says a lot if you guys haven't watched him.
I remember watching his... stream where we practiced not swearing.
Yeah, we also
that didn't go too well, actually.
We got $20 from Gautier Chiquetto saying, great job, guys, supporting you from France. United we're strong, united will win.
You can't really do anything on this boss, which is a shame. It's slower to hit him over, except on the last hit, which is really dumb.
So Sonic Jam can make up some time.
I've seen it. The blue guys was talking about. I need to set a timer for this bit.
How is the song champ coming back?
Do you want me to do it?
No, I'll do it.
Which one? I think there are three.
Okay, we got $30 from Peter Anson, who said, I love what you guys are doing. I can't decide to put my money towards, so I'll let whoever's reading the comments right now choose a challenge. I'm going to put that towards the Trihex and Caleb shirtless arm wrestle fund. $30 in there, please.
No. Better, though.
Why did you get the damn
because
of that. That's how it's meant to go.
That's not how I want it to go.
Well, tough.
You're lucky I know...
Okay, so this is the last of the vertically wrapping levels. In this, you're gonna see a lot of screen wraps, and we didn't really explain what's happening with the screen wrap. It's kind of the same as the left to right level wrapping. The way that the game treats the your vertical position in the way the game treats your vertical position in these levels, because you don't have a map point of reference. It just uses the camera as the point of reference, and the top of the top of where the camera is zero. So if you jump off that, you actually go negative, and so you have exactly the same.
Yeah, weird thing about this level, if you're here and Tails isn't, he'll never come back. He'll just hit the top of the level and then just go off the top of the level again. It's really dumb. It happened in one of our runs, and I was on pace for a PB, and then he just didn't come back ever.
Okay, we got $20 from Zilch, who says, $20 in honor of Rikers winning the first pool with 12. The mics know why. Put it in for naming Pokemon Gold rival SMK.
Oh.
And then Maxime Basque says,
$20.
Yeah, thanks for the marathon. Really enjoying it so far. Here's $20 for a blue baby run of Binding of Isaac, because why not?
The baby is not an option.
Yeah, I don't know if it is. Solid.
Why did you push that?
It's not an option. There you go.
I mean, it's an option in the game, but he's not doing it.
Yeah, I guess pick a different thing if you want to contact a mod in IRC.
Oh, well.
He said a while ago that he was not actually doing
blue
beam.
No! Like, what are you doing?
Just let me up there,
damn! No! Oh dear. Good.
Yeah, if that's in the wrong position, you can just get crushed as soon as you land there.
Alright, we got $40 from Michael Ingersoll saying it's 2013, a new year to say Rumble sucks.
No! Where did you go? There you are. Get me up there. Good. Hey, you can spin dash there. Oh yeah, I can do that thing now. But I didn't do anything different. There we go. Okay, this boss gets destroyed by instant shield. Boss music, eyes and stuff.
Wow. Okay, we got $40 from Soli saying, great work this year, guys. Best of luck to Werster and Mike. As for what the money goes through, let the brothers decide. $20 for Mike and $20 for Werster. Have fun and game on from Nephilim Zero. So that's more money for you guys to play with later.
Okay, there's another sub-pixel trick here. Yeah. You can just go through that floor completely random. Saves like 9 seconds or something?
Yeah, about 9 seconds.
Oh, what?
Yeah, we got $10 from Daniel Walker who says, hi, haven't lost anyone close to from cancer, and here's hoping more people like me crop up soon. Also, $10 towards a shark for Pokemon Gold Starter. The Shark Queen has spoken.
Yes! That rarely ever happens.
No, you can... The starter's fine, just not the actual name.
The trainer name,
yeah.
$10 from John Arker, who says, put this towards the Batman Beyond costume for Arkham City. Thanks for organizing this. My job is very boring. You're not alone there, buddy. We got $40 from Benis Skarstein, or Skarstein, something along those lines. Good job, guys. Lots of fun and for a great cause. Shout out for my friend Anders, who is also watching the stream tonight.
What? He's normally always stuck there forever. That saves a bunch of time.
That's where the most distant is dealing with the tails from this room.
Yes! Yes, we did find that out once.
Yeah, this is just the worst level for speedrunning because there's ramps everywhere instead of like straight ground, so you just get all these dumb ramp jumps. Hit you.
Yeah, watch carefully when Tails gets hit. Okay, so this is the level we switch on.
There's a trick at the end that Michael's just better at, and so he does it instead of me. It's also a level that he in general does better because it's just the type of level. There's just like time jumps instead of frame perfect, absolute random crap.
Nope.
He's not too fond of that. Never mind.
Oh, what? That's
nice. Can you just drop me in the ground? I never do that to you.
Oh, no, never. Is that too? Okay. If I'm lucky, everything will be out of the way and I'll get to keep it, but I'm not lucky today.
We got $150 from Chris Karstorff, who said, thanks for having fun, guys.
I got hit by the rock exploding on the level above.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
Says, keep it up. Shoutouts to Hash Idol Sports.
I think it's just the game going, seriously, dudes.
What have you done to it? Who's got the fastest spin now?
Probably me, but not by no much. He's just much better at precision and collecting himself when he makes a mistake. I'm no more at all. You dropped me again.
Oh, I thought I saved you. I tried to stay in the air.
Oh, I got him.
Do you mind if I interrupt for a second? So you have something from Sparking Meteor. Is Werster Mike's brother? They look alike.
First go.
Oh. So this
not
is,
over yet.
This is the trick we're talking about. This is one.
Oh wait, I'm thinking with Tails where you have to spin dash in the
end of the block. Yeah, that's the top.
There we go. Alright.
So that basically cuts out a massive, 2 minute auto-scroller boss?
Yeah.
Only you can cut out sky chains like that. Okay, so yeah. Knuckles is really powerful. There's only one way to beat him, and that's to work together.
Perfect. Okay, so Knuckles takes 8 hits to kill, but his invulnerability works differently to every other boss in the game. What happens is that his invulnerability resets as soon as he hits the ground. So by rolling back, Knuckles kind of crouches, and then if you run Tails into his sprite during that time, he gets really confused when he tries to rebound when he gets hit, and instead he just stays in place, and so Sonic connects with him for like 4 or 5 frames there and gets 4 or 5 hits all at once.
Wow.
So it only takes 2 hits.
Nice storytelling touch right there. If Sonic does absolutely nothing, Sonic's happens.
Yeah, just at the moment he breaks the door.
Knuckles.
Alright.
How's the Sonic Jam go? We're almost done here.
Okay, we got $10 from Arrow saying, "Hey gang, just wanted to congratulate you for an awesome start to what I'm sure will be the best AGDQ yet. You're all the man. Put this towards acting out the play in FF9. Wish I was there. Hopefully I'll make the next one."
God damn. Small jump. I have the habit of doing a big jump there, and if
yeah,
you hit that
if
wall,
you hit the side, you cannot make it.
You're dead.
Dead.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, so this level doesn't vertically wrap, but it gets really confused because it's really tall. That's not a screen wrap, but it kind of looks like one. There's normally a kill plane down where I went, but instead it was just like, oh yeah, you're at the top of the level now. What are you doing?
What are you doing? You got me hit.
You were meant to play for that. I was playing for the slide.
I'm supposed to play for the slide.
I always play for the slide. Why would I not play for the slide? I'm on the right edge. That's where you play from the slide. You were on the left side of the stage. You were playing for nothing.
You just dropped me for no reason.
It's okay, guys. They are fighting. When they're fighting, it's just fine.
we'll cut the stream. We're all good to us, really.
Yeah. All right, we got $30 from Alexandria White, who says, "You guys are doing so well. Keep up the good gaming." Good gaming, okay. I don't know anyone who has cancer, but I do know that it needs to be stopped. $30 to go towards the Wii U. Have fun.
Okay, so this is a Tails-only path right here. It's not apparent why until the very end.
Yeah, when I die, because Michael doesn't know how to fly.
Those spikes can crush you if you stay there too long, by the way. I dropped.
So here, I can't go up there, so
yeah.
I need Tails to
so
fly
this
me
is
up.
A huge shaft, which obviously you can't get up the lightning shield. Oh!
There we go.
So if you both hold up against the side, Tails makes a clean catch there every time, so that's...
Unless you hold right. If you hold right against a right wall, occasionally Sonic can just go straight through for whatever reason.
Yeah, how Tails catches Sonic is really bizarre and we don't fully understand it.
I'm just waiting for one of you to mess up and then you start yelling at each other.
Yeah, it's no fun when it goes well, is it?
No.
Yeah.
Okay, so Hydrosity 1 is the dumbest boss, but this is the hardest boss. Yeah. And they are like, oh dear. Wow, that's awful. I got a terrible pattern on the spikes and he just shot one straight up.
Okay, so we kind of tag team that way, right?
Do you want me to just
crush? Yeah,
Jeff,
just go.
Crush Jeff, right. Item box.
That's the other stupid thing about it is it's hitbox is very dumb.
Oh my god.
Yeah, see it like that. Yeah. So there was twice where it looked like I would have hit it, but the laser's hitbox actually extends higher than you think it does.
Okay, we got $50 from Linda Davies, says, "Hi guys, lag.mum here. Really enjoying the Sonic games. I lost my fab to cancer last year, so this means even more. Keep it up, you are doing a great job."
Alright, thank you very much.
28,000
viewers. Oh
wow.
Okay. That death isn't because he sucks. He does suck, but not. That's not why.
That was intentional, that death. Okay, so now I'm gonna go for a frame perfect, again, subpixel alignment trick here.
Alright.
And if I miss it, I can easily die. Okay. Nah, too early. Yeah, I'm dead. Wait, can I save this one?
No, I can't remember.
Oh yeah, okay, so I'm either trapped. Okay, I see.
Okay.
Right.
So now we're stuck on the top path.
Yeah, this is just bad. Yeah. Whatever.
But if you saw the we just flew straight through it.
Oh my god.
Go.
No!
What
are you doing?
What are you doing?
Black box on the top right there.
I wasn't paying attention. I had to keep up with whatever Michael was.
Yeah,
Cheers, Tails. No, I got this. Okay, so there's another...
Oh, I've got to go away then.
Okay, so I hit this checkpoint just in case I die here, because dying is all that's
worth it. Oh,
damn it! That was good, and then...
Okay. That's so Tails is going to respawn where Sonic is, so that's why Sonic's lined it up. Okay.
Alright.
So that saves about 15 seconds of going around. It's not the best zip we could do in the stage, but it's still kind of cool. Alright, I got one question. Is Trihex in the room?
Dude, I think he's still sleeping, man. He's only had like 14 hours sleep today, so... Not a joke.
I'd clap for if someone was able to get 14 hours of sleep. That's not how this works.
Dude, him and Cosmo are machines, man. They just shut off and do nothing. Alright, we got $20 from Michael Gosvig, who says, greetings from Denmark, you guys are doing a fantastic job. Split the money where you think will be most needed. Looking forward to another couple fantastic days. So more of $10 for you guys. We got $10 from Zach SK, who says, shout outs to Werster, aka xxtorkle_lover420xx. An excellent Pokemon runner. Put this towards the FMI for the Link to the Past file name.
Nice.
God damn.
It's still on the right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Awesome.
I'd rather play Sonic the Hedgehog Genesis, the Game Boy Advance port.
Don't
say those things.
Oh, I'm...
What?
You're the one who to go, damn!
Okay, yeah, loving the teamwork.
Yeah, okay. Everyone quiet for it. The Trihex!
Oh!
4, 5... You missed the whole run.
Were you at Denny's?
No, I was supposed to be up by noon.
All right. Okay. So we're gonna do a quick
So she's over here, man.
Okay.
So the game. Okay. That's the main.
So this
game
does have a real versus mode.
Oh yeah.
And so these guys can demonstrate
strong man, right?
Yep. Yeah, strong man.
This guy can play immerse the person.
This would be good. Then this is all he does. So he's supposed to win.
I've only gotten as far as that.
Oh yeah. So we're actually gonna play on
my first try.
That one still works. So there's a glitch, but it's not one maybe defined as a glitch. But Tails in this version can stand on slopes and spin dash. Nobody else in any other version can spin dash.
Punch out.
And so that's really useful for the first level. And in the second level, the target gets wrecked in slopes 3
launch. Yeah, right.
Yeah. Alright, well that was awesome. Probably. Okay, gotta get some quantum, sorry. Alright, well that was awesome. Thank you, Warster and Mike89 for that great Sonic 3 and Knuckles run. Next up we've got Sinister One playing Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, including blindfolded Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, knocking out Mike Tyson, and what was the other thing?
Midget Sandman Glitch.
How was I gonna forget that one? Alright, sweet. All right, and let's power through some donations. So if I get kind of a mild roar. All right. Oh, okay, let's do this. We got a $10 donation from Noah Tomlin, the Englishman, otherwise known as. I'm currently cowering in the New York room with a nasty headache and some black coffee, but I hope to rejoin the festivities in time for the Mario block. Anyways, here's some money for Cod of War, aka the only costume in God of War 2. Long live the Swift Fish. We got $15 from Joseph McKercher. Sonic Runners, thank you for making me feel like I never actually played these games before. Great job. Here's for the play in Final Fantasy IX. Does this sound all right? This is okay. We got $10 from Jeff Boucher. Watched you guys for over 3 years and now are partly the reason for my starting up running myself. Use this $10, however, Flicky likes because he works too damned hard on the Sunday sequence break.
That's a low, that's a lie.
$10, where do you want to put it?
Oh, me? Dude, more man flesh, please. Caleb and Trihex.
More on Caleb's man flesh. Mixed with Trihex's man flesh. Oh, that sounded... All right, well... Why did I say that? I think I'm getting kicked out of the marathon for saying that. All right. I didn't recommend doing it. We got a $20 donation from Matthew Mastromaro. Hey guys, great job on the marathon. $20 for the cause and a shot at the MTPO hardcover, the Mike Tyson's Punch-Out hardcover. Matthew Mastromaro. Unfortunately, you need to donate the $20 during Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, actually, not during the Sonic block. We are happy for your $20 donation, but again, we try to keep it time-stamped. Thank you, though. We got a $10 donation from Brett Alexander. Thanks to all the speedrunners for the great runs and props to serving a great cause. Just wanted to say, hey to my grandfather who beat anal cancer late last year. Here's to you, Papa. Got a $30 donation from Rory Connor. Keep up the great work, guys. Military schedule makes it hard to stay with you, but I'm with you as much as I can. Thank you, Rory. We got a $25 donation from Sylvester DeBinion. No equipment upgrades except dash boots, Mega Man X. Unfortunately, that is not an option. We're only going for 100%, because that category is beast. We got $30 from Valentine Offner. Great idea. Continue like this from France. Hello to TL Ponies from YolTOTL. You need more ponies next time. We got $20 from Curtis Tamblin. I don't think I've seen any other game that told walls to kindly go and mind their own business as Sonic 3, except for perhaps the most epic of Sonic games, Sonic 2006. Please put this to Sonic 2006 final chapter. Thank you, Curtis. We got $40 from Alexander Kronk. Last name is pronounced Kronk. I was close. Today, my best friend is starting her first day of chemo down in California. Thank you for everything you do. We got a $10 donation from Eli Lakritz. Sup, bros? What's up, Eli? Thanks for doing an amazing thing for humanity. I'm donating to put Saget in Pokemon Gold. My $10 goes towards the Pokemon Gold's rival name being Saget. Uh-oh. We've got a $150 donation from Poxnor. And so it... Please put this $150 towards naming Zidane Poxnor. This donation is in memoriam of my father, CST Levo. Levo? Is that how you say it? Sorry, hold on. CST Levo?
Levote.
CST Levote of the Edmonton Police Department. He taught me that the most important thing